I remember that day very well. So it was April the 23rd, 2013. I woke up with a terrible headache. I got out of bed. I was dizzy. I was stumbling, and I kept thinking, I'm going to get better. Once I get into the shower, once I brush my teeth, I'll be much better. But that didn't happen. What actually happened was I got dizzier and dizzier. Because I was a healthy person, I did not think that I was having a stroke. I never would have thought it was a stroke.
Stroke is just what it sounds like. It's a bolt out of the blue. You're struck down. Something happens suddenly. Blood going to the brain is cut off, and it's cut off pretty much in one of two ways. You get a blood clot, so you don't get blood which carries oxygen and nutrients to the blood cells and it gets cut off. Or you get a blood vessel that bursts and you get a blood clot in the brain and it destroys brain tissue. The type of stroke where a blood vessel closes off and you get a clot is much more common than the one where one bursts and you get a hemorrhage.
So it's estimated that about 800,000 people in the United States suffer a stroke each year.
It's the leading cause of disability in adults. The word we use to try and get people to remember is FAST. So is something happening to your face? Are you getting numbness and tingling or paralysis of your face? The A is arm. Is your arm weak or, again, numbness and tingling? S is for speech. Is your speech slurred? Do you have trouble finding the words that you want to use? And then T is time. Time is of the essence.
When Brianna was 12 months of age, she was violently shaken by a babysitter. She was shaken so hard that it caused hydrocephalus and a traumatic brain injury, as well as a stroke. She lost the entire functionality of the right side of her body, so she had to learn everything all over again.
So if you ask me what are the three key components of rehabilitation, and the first bucket are the physical problems, the second bucket would be the cognitive problems, thinking problems, and the third bucket would be the behavior problems that occur after an injury. You need to get enough of a dose of rehabilitation to get the brain to repair itself. If you wanted sort of a short list that you could keep in your mind of, gee, what can I do so I can put myself at a lower risk for stroke? I mean, the big ones are, okay, know what your blood pressure is and control it. If your doctor tells you you have hypertension, take the pills and monitor it. If you have diabetes, control your blood sugar. If you have high cholesterol, hopefully you'll be able to tolerate the medications and take them. Exercise, we know that exercise helps. If you're older, you need to learn to be able to take your pulse and know if you have atrial fibrillation. And the last one I would just put is if you smoke, stop. I mean, it's that simple.
Hanging out with and exchanging stories and being with others who've been through similar situation is absolutely invaluable. It's not easy to get all of what you need, and you really have to look at it as a maze and steps along the way, and not just that you're going to get all answers in one place. But we feel like we provide a great service by talking with people and helping them get through it.
I think going to the support group and hearing other people talk about what has happened to them has helped me to realize that I'm not the only person out there. Because I never gave up and because I knew what I could do and what I knew what I had done before, I knew that I would be able to do it again.
Don't lose hope. You know, we have friends that will now tell us, oh my gosh, we would have never thought that she'd be where she is today.
When stroke arrives on your doorstep, it doesn't affect you, it affects your whole family. But what's really important is rather than just focus on the negative aspects, the bad things that have happened, you and your family are still left with a lot of strengths, not just the weakness that the stroke or the brain injury caused. And by focusing on those strengths, you'll be able to get through that event. One of the most important qualities in any human being is resilience, the ability to bounce back. And human beings are spectacularly resilient. And this is going to be one of those times where you need to be resilient.